In the world of songwriting, where lyrics and melody intertwine to create magic, there is an unassuming enemy lurking in the shadows, and it's not lack of talent or creative inspiration that is the biggest threat to good songwriting. It's actually something far more unexpected. This enemy actually lives inside the good intentions of songwriters, but if we can't recognize it, it can creep into every song we write. In this video, I'm going to tell you what that enemy is and also how to avoid it. Lyrics like this make me cringe a little inside, and I suspect that they make you feel exactly the same way. And yet they pop up everywhere, and they actually pop up in the lyrics of people who are trying really hard not to write like that. Why? Well, here is the enemy of good songwriting. In the very noble intentions of songwriters to write songs that are universally relatable, the enemy is that we mistake universal for generic. Something that is universal is not the same thing as something that is generic. And in the attempt to write something that appeals to lots and lots of people, the mistake is to strip your lyrics of everything that actually makes them personal and therefore relatable. Universal ideas are experiences and emotions that are shared by lots of people. And the feeling when you hear a song like that is you deeply feel like, oh, me too. Like, that's exactly what it was like. That's exactly how it felt. And here is the paradox of great songwriting. And of course, I am specifically talking about lyric writing here. The paradox is, in order to successfully create that connection for our listeners, we do not want to strip our lyrics of all the idiosyncrasies and all the specifics that make that idea and experience and emotion come to life and feel real and true and authentic. We need to keep those details in the song because it's those details that conjure the details of someone else's life and make them feel like me too. Let me show you an example of this from a beautiful song that absolutely nails the idea that including specific details is actually what makes a song more relatable and therefore more universal. And the song is Nothing by Bruno Major. So I'm actually going to sing the first verse for you because it totally captures the beauty of the specifics that he puts into the lyrics.
Track suits and red wine, movies for two. We'll take off our phones and turn off our shoes. We'll play Nintendo, though I always lose. 'Cause you watch the TV while I'm watching you.
Let's see how we can ruin this song by letting the enemy creep in and mistaking universal for generic.
We sit on the couch, just you and me. We love to hang out nowhere I'd rather be.
Can you feel yourself dying just a little bit inside? So generic does not mean universal, and in fact it often has the opposite effect because it removes everything that actually triggers the life experience that creates that sympathetic response from a listener and creates that moment of connection. When we take out the details, we take out the relatability, which actually makes something less universal, not more universal. The late and great Leonard Cohen said it beautifully in his wonderful interview in the book Songwriters on Songwriting. We seem to be able to relate to detail. We seem to have an appetite for it. It seems our days are made of details. And if you can get the sense of another person's day in details, your own day of details is summoned in your mind in some way rather than just a general line like the days went by. It's better to say watching Captain Kangaroo, not watching TV. Sitting in my room with that hopeless little screen, not just TV, but hopeless little screen. I think those are the details that delight us. They delight us because we can share a life then. It's our sense of insignificance and isolation that produces a great deal of suffering. There's no better exercise that I know of for sharpening this technique of transforming ideas into specific details than the exercise called sense writing. And I've talked a lot about sense writing in other videos, which you can check out here and click on it and just bookmark it and go to it at the end. I've also included a free PDF in the link in the show notes, which is to an ebook I wrote called The 5 Best Exercises for Writing Great Lyrics, and sense writing is number one. So you can download that and really go into detail there. But I'm going to demo an exercise for you right now that's a sort of abridged version of sense writing and something that you can do really quickly to practice this idea of taking something general or generic and really transforming it into something that puts a picture in the mind of your listener. So here is the exercise. I call this exercise turning the dial because we're taking something that is generic and we're turning the dial up on the level of detail. So let's take a generic line like it was a normal, lovely Saturday afternoon. This line shows me nothing. It tells me something, but I see nothing and therefore I really don't feel much. Here is the exercise. I'm going to set a timer for 6 minutes and for 6 minutes straight, I'm going to come up with as many single lines as I can in 6 minutes that turn that generic idea into specific sense-based detail. The goal here is to really paint a picture. It's almost like a small little photograph that you're trying to take with words. Now, the lines don't need to be connected. In fact, they shouldn't be connected. They're just single little photographs of pictures that are designed to show a normal, lovely Saturday afternoon rather than merely telling about a Saturday afternoon. So I'm going to write one line and then I'm going to move on to the next. Let's have a go. All of these lines do such a lovely job of really painting a picture and it invites you into the world that I'm creating. Now, it's not that I'm gonna use all of these lines. It's not even if I wanted to use one of the lines that I would literally use the whole image. I can extract images out of it that really work hard to paint the picture. Let me show you this in action in another song. This is the lyric to the song Dearly Departed Friend by the American country bluegrass Americana band Old Crow Medicine Show. Now, this is the second verse to their song and their whole song is full of all kinds of incredible details that really draw us into the story. But I really want to show you this verse because it's related to the exercise we just did. So let's check this out. Barbecue grills and lawn mowers, kids on four-wheelers and ice cream trucks. Yeah, they buried you on a Saturday. Georgia lost to Tennessee. You would have liked that, I know. Afterwards, we went to O'Charlie's. Your mama's boyfriend got drunk saying it should have been me. And I wish it was him, I mean. So I went home, got drunk and watched the TV. Can you see here how the songwriters are actually painting the picture of a normal Saturday? Now, this song is not about a normal Saturday. This song is about attending the funeral of a friend, but it's actually the specificity of the imagery they're using to paint the image of a Saturday kind of just rolling on as normal out there, while actually the singer is experiencing a day that is unlike any other Saturday they've experienced, that really creates the emotion through the contrast of those two experiences. The normal Saturday out there and the funeral happening in the world of the songwriter. One little caveat that I want to put on the idea of including details into your song lyrics is we're not really talking about adding ornamentation onto your lyrics. I'm not talking about shoving in as many adjectives and adverbs as you can. In fact, adjectives and adverbs tend to also be enemies of good songwriting and good communication, but the importance of nouns and verbs cannot be overstated. I love this quote from the Stephen King book on writing. Stephen King here is talking about descriptive detail and he says, "For me, good description usually consists of a few well-chosen details that will stand in for everything else." In that Bruno Major song, tracksuits, red wine, and movies for two, it's just so beautiful. It tells us so much. It tells us about their relationship. It tells us about their age. It tells us about their level of comfort and intimacy with each other. It tells us that it's something romantic, but shows us the details of that, but not too many details. The inclusion of the playing Nintendo is so charming in that song. And again, it kind of tells us something really charmingly quirky and creates that sense of relatability. One thing I would love you to notice, however, in that verse is the almost total absence of adjectives and adverbs. So don't rely on adjectives and adverbs to do this job, but also understand that not every line of lyric needs to be dripping in the diamond dust of detail. Really look at your song lyrics and aim for 1 to 2 lines per section. And mostly here we're talking about verses, not even choruses. Choruses can do whatever they want to do. But in the verses where your job is to really paint the world of the song and draw us in to the who, when, where, and what of the song, really aim for 1 or 2 lines lines that use a few key specific images, mostly nouns and verbs, that do a lot and really help us enter the world of your song and connect with you and your experience of the world. If there are songs whose lyrics you absolutely love that do this in a really beautiful way, please let us know in the comments. And if you want to dive more deeply into sense writing, you can check out this video right here. Happy writing, guys. I'll see you next time.